Hi, I'm Kylie of Kylie M Interiors, online paint color consultant and e-design specialist. Today we're going to look at Benjamin Moore Stonington Gray. Stonington Gray is a gray paint color, so that means it has undertones, just like every other gray. You're going to be dealing with blue, green, or purple. When it comes to Stonington Gray, he does commit to a blue undertone. Now, blue itself can slide a bit blue-purple or blue-green. Stonington Gray can slide just slightly blue-green, but barely. If you don't like blue undertones, you probably won't like Stonington Gray, even though they are passive. Now, when it comes to LRV, LRV is light reflectance value, and it's a number that every paint color has that basically tells you how light or dark it is on a scale of 0 to 100. 0 is black, 100 is white. This guy's sitting at 59, so he's in the light range, but he's not in the washed out range. So if you have a super bright room, he's going to hold himself up pretty well and not wash out as much as a more traditionally lighter gray paint color would. But if you have a dark room, if you have crisp white trim, something like this, that would definitely help it out. But you really do need some good interior lighting to help it come to life. Now let's do some comparison, because when you choose whites and grays, comparison is one of the best ways to pick them. So let's start with one that everybody knows, Benjamin Moore Gray Owl. So you can see that difference there, right? Gray Owl has a higher LRV. I believe it's around 65. So you can see it's lighter. This is a more traditionally light paint color. So if you have that super bright room, might wash out a bit, might hold itself a bit better. You can also see that that blue undertone is coming up a bit more, right? Now, both of these, they're not icy cold grays, but they're not traditional warm gray paint colors. I call them my soft grays or my stormy grays. So it will really depend on your exposure. If you have north facing light, they're gonna look like cool grays. But if you have south facing light or afternoon western light, they're gonna look softer, not necessarily warm, but softer. Now, let's also look at Sherwin-Williams Tinsmith. Tinsmith, you can see that slightly lower LRV. I believe it's somewhere around 55. You can also see it commits a bit more to that blue undertone. It's a great option as well. I do have videos on most of these if you want to check them out, if you're curious to know more about them. As for white, if I'm going to partner Stonington Gray with a white paint color, say for cabinets, trim, that kind of thing, I'm going to keep it pretty simple. Chantilly lace. She had a pretty face. So Chantilly lace is a pretty legit white paint color. This color here is actually the most legit white, but it belongs to Bear. When it comes to Sherwin-Williams and Benjamin Moore, you're going to find Chantilly lace is pretty darn white. I like that crisp, clean look. Some people like the dynamic of a warmer white with a color like this, because the cool and warm can kind of bounce and play off of each other. And you can do that. But personally, if I'm going to choose a white, I'm going to keep things a little bit more simple. So that's Benjamin Moore Stonington Gray. I hope you'll visit me on my website, www.kyliemminteriors.ca. I have over 300 articles, color reviews, decorating ideas, affordable update ideas, and I have a wicked search function, so you can type in almost any keyword and you'll have access to all those articles and can read for days. Please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel, and thank you for watching.